हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस वीडियो इज द कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ द लेसन उटंकास गुरु दक्षिणा. सो लेट्स कंटिन्यू फ्रॉम हियर. उटंका थैंक्ड हर एंड स्टार्टेड फॉर होम. डस्क वाज फॉलिंग एंड ही वाज टायर्ड. लीनिंग अगेंस्ट द ट्रंक ऑफ अ ट्री ही रेस्टेड, प्लेसिंग द इयर रिंग्स ऑन द ग्राउंड बिसाइड हिम. सडनली ही सॉ अ हैंड स्नैच द इयर रिंग्स and disappear. He sprang to his feet and turned round in time to see a man dressed in rugs running through the forest. Utanka ran after him as fast as he could when suddenly the man changed into a snake which wriggled into a hole in the ground. So Utanka, he got the earring from the queen and he thanked her for giving the earrings. So he thanked the queen and he started towards the home, okay, where he was living. To that place inside the forest he started to travel. Dusk was falling, that means the evening time just before the sunset, so that time is called dusk. Dusk was falling and he was tired. Utanka, after such a long travel, he went to palace and he is returning, no? So he was very tired and he was leaning against the trunk of the tree. Okay, on a tree he was leaning and he was taking rest, placing the earrings on the ground next to him. Beside him means next to him. Suddenly a hand came and it snatched the earrings and the hand disappeared. So Utanka, he got up so fast, okay, that's why the word sprung is used, so like a spring, okay. He got up to his feet and he turned around to find out who have taken the earring. So he saw a man dressed in rugs. Rugs means dirty cloth, torn dirty cloth is called rugs. So the man in such a cloth, he was running through the forest with the earring. Utanka, he followed the man as fast as he could, but the man have changed into a snake. Okay, so the man have changed into a snake and he went inside the ground. Wriggled means how the snake and all they will go, so that movement is called wriggled. Okay, so like a snake he wriggled and he went inside the hole in the ground. Utanka was greatly distressed, for try as he did, he could think of no way to get through so small a hole. He sat down to lament his fate when an old man appeared before him. So Utanka was very much upset. He was in a great stress now. Okay, so he was sitting and he was lamenting his bad fate. Okay, lamenting means he was saying how bad his fate is. Though he got the earring, he lost it. So because of that, he was sitting and lamenting, sitting next to the hole where the snake went inside. So that time an old man appeared before Utanka. "Do not worry, my son," he said. "I have come to help you." Even as he spoke, there was thunder and lightning and a great thunderbolt fell. The whole earth shook with the force of it. Suddenly, all was quiet again, but next to where Utanka stood was a big hole in the ground. So when he was sitting and lamenting, he saw an old man, no? So he came to Utanka and he said, "Don't worry, my son." Okay, he came there to help him. Like that he told to Utanka. When he was telling that thunder and lightning was coming, okay, like a thunder fall it was, the whole earth shook with that force, that means the earth was shaking. Then after that everything was quiet. That time Utanka saw that small hole have changed into a big hole on the ground. Okay, Utanka entered the hole and found himself in the kingdom of the Serpent King. He walked slowly along and came to two women weaving a piece of cloth. He asked them the way to the palace of the serpent king. They did not heed him and went on with their weaving. He saw that their cloth was made of black and white threads. Then after entering the hole, Utanka was inside the kingdom of the serpent. Okay, the serpent king only have taken the earrings, no? So he was inside the kingdom of serpent now. He was walking slowly. That time he saw two women weaving a piece of cloth. Okay, those cloth were made of black and white threads. So he went to those women and he asked the way to the palace of serpent king. Okay, these women, they did not give a response to Utanka. They did not heed, means they did not notice him. Okay, they did not notice Utanka and they were keep on weaving the cloth. Next, he came to a wheel with 12 spokes. Six boys turned the wheel round and round. "What are you doing?" he asked to the boys. They did not answer him and went on with their work. So he went on till he saw a man with a beautiful horse. So next, Utanka started to move from there and he saw 12 spokes on a wheel. Okay. And six boys were turning that wheel. They were making a round out of that wheel. It is rounding. Utanka asked to those boys, "What are you doing?" But those boys didn't answer him. They were keep on doing their work. Then Utanka again he started moving and he saw a man with a beautiful horse. Utanka went up to him. He saw so struck with the horse that he bowed respectfully to the man and said, "O Lord, I bow to you. Grant me a favor." Then Utanka went to that man who was coming with the horse. So he was very much struck with that beautiful horse and the man. So he was spontaneously, he was giving respect to the man by showing bow. Okay, he was bending and showing his respect. Then he said, "O Lord, I bow to you, grant me a favor." Favor means give me a help. Okay, you have to grant me some help. So for that sake, he was talking to that man. The man turned and said, "What can I do for you?" Utanka replied, "Let the serpent king be brought under my power." So the man asked, "What do you want?" to Utanka. Utanka replied, he want the serpent king to be under his control, because the serpent king only took the earrings, no? So he have to be under the control of Utanka so that he can get the earrings back. "Blow into this horse," the man replied. Utanka went up to the horse and blew, and from every hair of the horse body darted a flame that shot through every space in the kingdom of the serpent king. It burnt the houses till all serpents rushed out, begging Utanka to save their lives. So what the man said, the man asked Utanka to blow into this horse. He was having a horse, no? So on the hairs of the horse, the man asked to blow. Okay, blow air. So Utanka also went near the horse and he started to blow. He was keep on blowing on the hairs of the horse, and every hair of the horse, they turned into flame and they went to the every space of the kingdom of the serpent and started to burn the houses there. Okay. So all the houses are burning. So all the serpents came rushing out and they begged to Utanka to save their life. They know that Utanka was the reason. So that only the fire have set their houses. So they came to Utanka to save their life. Let the serpent king return the earrings, said Utanka. All the serpents then clamored for the king to return the earrings. He did. So what Utanka said, he said the serpent king should return the earrings. So all the serpents, so all the snakes, all serpents means snakes, all the snakes then clamored. Clamored means they raised their voice, they made noise together for the king to return the earrings. So no other go for the serpent king also. So he returned the earrings to Utanka. The man gave Utanka the horse, and in a few moments he was back at the hermitage just in time to give the earrings to his guru's wife for the feast. She blessed him for his great courage. So next, the man with the horse, he gave the horse to Utanka. Okay, so in just few minutes, in few moment, Utanka was back to his hermitage in the forest. Okay, there the guru's wife was there for the feast. So he was on time and he gave the earrings to her for the feast. So she was very happy and she blessed him for his courage, because he was a young boy. But he made such courageous attempt to go to the city and palace, and he got the earrings from the queen and he brought it. So for that sake, she blessed the boy. When Utanka related this adventures, his master smiled and said, "The dirty liquid you drank, my boy, was ambrosia. It will give you eternal youth. The two maidens weaving the black and white threads are the night and the day. The man was the god of rain and the horse was the god of fire. You have been well looked after, my child, and deserve my blessings. Go into the world now, for great fortune awaits you." Then he went and described the adventure that he made to master. Master, he said that the liquid that you drank first was the ambrosia, that is amrita. Okay, so that will give you eternal youth. Eternal means no end at all. He will be young forever. Okay. And the two maidens were weaving, no, that was the day and night, black and white threads, that is day and night. Maiden means unmarried women. And the man and the horse, he saw, no, it was god of rain and god of fire. He have met the gods. So the master said, you are a child who is deserving the blessings. So he said, you can go and face the world, and great fortune will come him. Fortune means luck. Okay. Thus Utanka have fulfilled his duties, went into the world to seek his living. He was not as other men, for he knew that God protected him. He had nothing to fear. So now he had fulfilled all his duties, because the duty is to give Guru Dakshina. He gave that, and he have won the heart of the master. So now he is not an ordinary man. He is very much extraordinary. Why? Because he have met the God and God have protected him. So now he had no fear. Okay, nothing to fear. He had nothing to fear now. So now he is very courageous and he can face the world successfully. There ends the lesson. That's all for this video. Thank you, children.